Are being released back onto the streets and cities across America thanks to district attorneys that were bought and paid for by George Soros. Here's one America's Pearson Sharp.
As riots erupt across the nation, one man is emerging as the face behind the violence, George Soros. The radical left-wing billionaire who's been declared an enemy of the state in his home country of Hungary has poured over $220 million into domestic terrorist organizations like Black Lives Matter. And thanks to Soros' work reforming the criminal justice system, these fascists are being released right back onto the streets as soon as they're arrested. And to do that, he's literally buying district attorneys in cities across the nation. These DAs are usually highly unqualified, such as the 2018 candidate for a district attorney that he spent millions backing in San Diego, Genevieve Jones-Wright. Normally, these unqualified DAs wouldn't stand a chance against someone like Summer Steffen in San Diego, who has had decades of experience and is very popular with her community and with police for being someone fair and trustworthy. But with a few million dollars help from George Soros, all that changes, and you suddenly have a candidate whose only experience as a public defender trying to keep criminals out of jail. That's how you end up with DAs like Kim Fox in Cook County, Illinois. She won her election with money from Soros and then pushed through policies like not charging shoplifters who stole less than $1,000, which of course saw a massive surge in shoplifting. If only someone could have seen that coming. She's also the same woman who disgraced herself with the mishandling of the Jussie Smollett's hate crime hoax against himself last year. Soros also wants to degrade our quality of life here in America. We live too nice, too comfortably. We should feel guilty for living better than people in third world countries. If they can't live in clean cities, neither should we. San Francisco is a perfect example of this. We all know how the city has become a byword for degeneration, crime, homelessness, and filthy streets. So Soros gets people like San Francisco DA Chesa Boudin, who refuses to prosecute people for peeing or defecating in the streets. Imagine that. But what would you expect from a guy who was raised by parents who were not only members of the left-wing terrorist group, it really is a terrorist group, I'm not just being dramatic, but were also convicted for murdering two police officers and a security guard? You can't make this up. He stated in his campaign that he will not prosecute people for camping in the streets or blocking sidewalks or even soliciting public sex. And he's also on board for defunding the police. Of course, why would you need them? They aren't even allowed to do their jobs. And then you have St. Louis Circuit Attorney Kim Gardner, whose campaign got major boosting from Soros and who announced she was bringing felony charges against Mark and Patricia McCloskey. These are the people Soros and the Democrats want to be in charge of our justice system. Is it any wonder that you have entire cities now burning down and criminals running free? This is the Democratic Party. And unless George Soros is stopped by a legal system brave enough to challenge his treasonous activities, he will continue promoting and installing puppet district attorneys across the country, ensuring that every neighborhood in America will soon look like this.